brothers and sisters. Once again, it's time for Sunday morning worship. This is Pastor Surles coming to you from Coates Chapel Free Will Baptist Church. Let us go into a word of prayer. Bring all wondering minds in. Let us pray. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Lord, we thank you on this morning, God, for new mercies. God, we thank you, for God, your mercy is more than we can ever imagine. We don't understand it, but we know that it is there and that it is truth. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, knowing that we don't deserve it, but because of your love, you gave it to us anyway. What is mercy, God? Mercy is something that's given to somebody when they deserve something else. And God, we thank you because we've been blessed beyond compare. Now, God, we ask that everyone in Facebook land lift up their heads. Oh, ye gates, be lifted up, you ancient doors, for the King of Glory. Who is the King of Glory? The Lord that's strong in battle. Who is the King of Glory, brothers and sisters? The Lord who's strong and mighty. Brothers and sisters, as the Lord is coming into this place on this morning, as the Lord is coming into your lives on this morning, things will begin to change. Come on in, God, and have your way. We thank you now, God, for feathers falling to the ground, for strongholds, God, being broken, for strong man being chased back, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, for ways being made, for doors being opened. God, we thank you, God, for the name, in the name of Jesus, for your grace and your mercy. We just bless and magnify and exhort your name, asking that you have your way on today. Touch, God, from heart to heart, God. Touch, God, from mind to mind. Touch, God, from soul to soul. God, increase our faith in the name of Jesus, knowing that we put all of our trust and our faith in you, knowing that all things are possible only through you. God, bless the mind of the preacher on this morning, God. Touch her from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet, knowing that if you touch her, she'll touch us. God, in the name of Jesus, let your word and your power and your anointing overflow on this morning in the name of Jesus. God, touch, God, the heart that stand near as hell on today, God. God, touch them down, God. Know that they're lonely. They need a touch from you on this morning, God. And God, bring a rainbow word, God. A word that's going to change lives, God. A word that's going to inspire, God. A word that's going to turn situations around. We stand high up this morning with hallelujah and glory to your name. And we ask this prayer in the name of the blessed Father, Son, and blessed Holy Spirit, and in Jesus' name. And the church said, amen. Brothers and sisters, please put your hands together now for our praise and worship song.
Now we're here to encourage you to walk into your new season, a season of freedom and a season of victory. Here it is.
By the hand of the Almighty, I've been set free, healed, delivered.
We're gonna sing that again.
By the hand.
and sisters, when you have your victory, you have your joy, you have your peace, you have your hope, and you have your strength. I am walking in victory.
Amen, amen.
In the name of Jesus. Brothers and sisters, at this time, I will be reading the word of God on this morning. Our scripture will be coming from John chapter 2, verses 15 through 18. I will give you a couple of seconds to get it. And it reads as follows. And when he had made a scourge of a small cord, he drove them all out of the temple, and the sheep and the oxen, and poured out the changers'
money, and overthrew the tables, and said unto them that sold doves, take these things hence, make not my father's house a house of merchandise. And his disciples remembered that it was written, the zeal of thine house hath eaten me up. Then answered the Jews and said unto him, what sign showeth thou us unto us, seeing that thou doest these things? The word of God for the blessed children of God. Please go with me in a word of prayer. Oh, heavenly and righteous Father, Abba, Father, we say unto you, because you are our Father. Lord, we were once wretches undone. A wretch, God, is something that you can't hold down, that has to be propelled back up as a regurgitation. But God, you didn't regurgitate us, God. You kept us in the name of Jesus. Not only did you keep us, God, but you held us in your bosom. You held us in your arm, and you're continuing to hold us together. Lord God, without you, we are helpless. We are useless. And God, it is hopeless. But with you, God, we are powerful. We are magnificent, and we are champions. We are walking in victory. God, we have our peace. God, we have our hope.
God, we have our joy, and God, we certainly have our strength. Strengthen us on today, God. God, move by your power and by your strength. God, nothing is more powerful than you. Nothing can stand in your way. God, we thank you now for departing, God, the trials and tribulations that are ahead of us, knowing, God, that you have already won the victory, knowing, God, that the only battle we have, God, is amongst ourselves in the name of Jesus. God, Satan can attack, but he's already been defeated, but he will attack us, God, as individuals. And God, as we keep our hands stayed on your hands and held in your hands, God, we know, God, that we will win the battle, God, in the name of Jesus. God, touch, God, every person under the sound of my voice. Some people are going through, God, tough and dire situations, but God, we know that God, if they concentrate, God, and lean and depend and cast their understanding upon you, God, you will make a way of escape, and you will make a way out of no way. Not saying it's going to get hard, God, but you are leading them every step of the way in the name of Jesus. We're thinking now, God, God, for making ways out of no ways, God, for giving us a clear understanding of who you are, God, by lifting us, God, out of troubled waters in the name of Jesus, and placing us on the rightful shore in the name of Jesus. We magnify and lift up your holy and righteous name, God. We praise you, we worship you, God. We magnify you, you're matchless. God, you're set apart from your creation. And God, we know as long as we continue to move, God, and listen, God, and abide in your ways, God, we know, God, that you will foresee us, God, through any situation we find ourselves going through. God, touch the preacher on this morning, God. God, empty her of herself, God. She's nothing but a dusty lip of clay, God. Nothing but a bag of flesh, God. But with you, God, she's all powerful, God. God, she can rein in, God, in the name of Jesus, things that your people are in need of on this morning, God. God, touch right now your people, Lord. They need a touch from you, God. They can't make it without you. They don't know how they're going to make it. And God, I know without a shadow of a doubt, we're not going to let you know, God, until you bless us in the name of Jesus. Let your power fall. Let your letter rain fall right now, God. Let your former rain fall, God. Shower us with your blessings, God, from on high, God. We thank you now. We magnify your name. We lift up your name. And God, touch, God, the one that standeth near as hell on this morning, God. God, knowing, God, that they're running from you, God. But God, I know, God, that you never leave them, nor we ever forsake them, God. Because you came into your own, God, and you died for them, God, so that they may live now, God. I ask that they live on today in the name of Jesus. Let them turn around, God, and seek, God, your face, and seek your instructions, and serve you, and be about your your ways, God, in the name of Jesus. Let the will, God, be given unto you so that your will may be done in their life. We thank you now for your will, God. Continue, God, to write the stories of each and every individual, God, under the sound of my voice. Know that it will be a happy ending, God. God, it will be a fairy tale ending, because when it's all said and done, God, we hear you say, We welcome into the joy of the Lord, thou good and faithful servant. We thank you, Lord. We magnify you and we bless your holy and righteous name. And we ask this prayer in the blessed name of the blessed Father, the name of the blessed Son, and in the name of the blessed Holy Spirit. And in Jesus' name, amen and amen again. Please put your hands together for another song.
My testimony, everybody, how God favored me in spite of my enemies. And if God did it for me, he'll do the same thing for you. Don't worry about your haters. Your haters can't do nothing with you. Listen to your word.
Love is patient, caring. Love is kind.
Love is felt most.
Love is felt most when
you change your life.
They whispered about me.
They conspired against me.
Brothers and sisters, is it that refining and relaxing to comprehend that God's favor is on our life? When his favor is on our life, the musician said that he speaks life, health, and prosperity. I thank God for life, health, and prosperity. Brothers and sisters, we come to the time in the service where we can continue to participate. This is the act of giving. And one thing I know without a shadow of a doubt is you cannot be God-given. Look at what God has done. Brothers and sisters, checks are in the mail. Waves are being made. God is taking care of his people. Sometimes we have to go through something in order to come out. As a matter of fact, let me rephrase that. You will go through something because you have to come out. You don't want to stay in the midst of your trials and your tribulations. So when you give to the Lord, you're storing up treasures in heaven. The problem with most of us is we store up treasures in our own personal treasure chest, and we can't take it with us when we depart. But whenever we give to the kingdom of the Lord, we're storing up treasures in heaven where we can one day receive our rewards when Jesus Christ cracks the sky and he comes back to usher us back to that place called heaven. I ask that you have faith and store up your treasures in heaven on this morning. Pay your tithes and your offering. Remember, you cannot be God-given or giving. At this time of the service, we come down to the most important part. We come here on today to usher in God's presence, to let his will be done, and to hear a word from on high, so that we may be instructed, so that we may be corrected and reproved, and definitely inspired. Are you ready for inspiration on this morning? We have a vessel who is capable, a vessel who loves the Lord, a vessel who has integrity and dignity, a vessel who has love and compassion, a vessel who serves the Lord and is an advocate for his kingdom. She's always spreading the good news. And that vessel this morning is none other than Eldress Rosemary Surles, a.k.a. the First Lady of Coates Chapel Free Will Baptist Church. Please point your hands in this direction with me and say, Eldress Surles, let the Lord use you, and Eldress Surles, give us a word from on high. Eldress Surles, preach a while. After the next selection, the next voice you will hear is none other than Eldress Rosemary Surles.
You can't. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The song say you never lost a battle. And I got news for you on this morning. He never will. Any battle that God fights, he wins. Hallelujah. Our arms is too short to box with the Almighty God. So all the battles, he wins. And if you are a child of God on this morning, he will fight for you. Aren't you so glad about it? I don't know about you on this morning, but I'm so glad that he fights, hallelujah, for me, that he never loses a battle. Hallelujah. I thank and praise God for being in this building just one more time. Not with the dead, but with the living. Realizing he didn't have to, but he did. So first of all, I'll give honor to God, who is first in my life, giving honor to my pastor, Dr. Alfonso Surles, my husband, giving honor to my two beautiful daughters, Sister Jessica Bradshaw and Sister Alicia Surles, to my handsome son, Brother Travis Bradshaw, and to my beautiful goddaughter, Sister Miranda Simmons, and to everyone in their respectful places. Thank and praise God for you out there on Facebook land tuning in on this morning. I pray that the word will reach you on this morning and help you along the way. I come on this morning just to be a vessel for the Lord. Hallelujah. And I tell him, thank you. Hallelujah. On this morning, we'll be lifting up the scripture out of the book of John, chapter 2. And we will be lifting up verses 15 through 21. And it reads, "And when he had made a scourge of small cords, he drove them out of the temple, and the sheep and the ox, and poured out the changers' money and overthrew the tables, and said unto them that sold doves, take these things hence, make not my father's house a house of merchandise. And his disciples remembered that it was written, the zeal of thine house hath eaten me up. Then answered the Jews and said unto him, what sign showest thou unto us, seeing that thou doest these things? Jesus answered and said unto them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. Then said the Jews, 46 years was the temple in the building, and wilt thou rear it up in 3 days? In verse 21, but he spake of the temple of his body. Hallelujah. Of his body. You know, when I was growing up, my mother was a very neat, clean woman of God. And I grew up in a very large family. And we had to work on the inside out, doing chores. And there came a season in the year when spring cleaning was at hand. It went beyond straightening up. It was a deep cleaning. Windows was washed, floors was waxed, winter clothes were put away, spring clothes was brought out the attic and to be washed. We had to clean the blinds thoroughly. We had to clean the steps. And the list goes on. And there was no getting out of spring cleaning. See, in my mother's house, there was no excuses. Everybody worked together and did their part. There was never one person doing all of the chores. So she made sure no one was scheduled to do anything that day. She made sure no one was scheduled to work. So she took all the excuses out. So when you was assigned a chore to do, it was no excuses. You had to do what you had to do. And I shared that story with you on this morning so that I can leave a little thought with you on this morning. And it will be, Jesus is cleaning the temple. Jesus is cleaning the temple. We can clean our natural homes, but Jesus is cleaning the temple. As we look into the gospel lesson this morning, I'd like for us to think of Jesus cleansing our spirits. The temple is a form of spring cleaning. It is cleansing the temple, but the spiritual temple. You see, Jesus purges the house of God of all corruption and disorder. He stood against the secular trapping which had crept into the worship practices of the people of his day in order to make the temple pure and holy once more. In this sermon, also this morning, I'd like to take a moment to look at the lesson more closely, paying particular attention to how it speaks to us on today. The stirring begins of the Passover of the Jews was near. And Jesus went up to Jerusalem, as John 2 and 3 and 13 has stated, the Passover, you remember, was one of the holiest feast days of the Jewish faith. The Jewish celebrate the night on which God liberated the slaves in Egypt, sending the angel of death through the street of Ramses, taking the life of every firstborn male, but passing over the Israelites, on which the blood of the lamb was smeared on the door. I don't know about you on this morning, but where the blood is, he said here, Passover, is the blood of the lamb stamped on your door on this morning. Jesus is cleaning the temple. Preacher, what does this have to do concerning spring cleaning? Well, I'm so glad that you asked. What does it have to do with spring cleaning? You see, God is going on in the house of God now, and he's upset and eager to get back in the temple to assemble ourselves. See, we've been out for a long time because of COVID-19. Well, what we out, I don't know about you, but we need to take advantage of what God is trying to do within our spirit. So when we get back in the temple to assemble ourselves and worship him with family and friends, and so we can be all on one accord. Have I think we need to take advantage of the separation and cleanse ourselves inside and out from all things that's not pleasing in the eyesight of God. And get ready to worship him, because the book of Psalm picked it up in 96 and 9, and it says, oh, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. Jesus is cleaning the temple now, and hallelujah to his name. You see, spring normally comes around the 14th day of the month back then. You see, thousands of people were traveling to celebrate the Passover. They was making their sacrifices to God in their temple tasks. Now let's think about this logistic. Here the papal population has swelled from about 50,000 people to over 180,000 people at the Passover. You see, pilgrims was just passing through. That was coming through from the Persia area, the Syria area, the Egypt area, the Greece area, the Rome area. Now that's a lot of hungry mouths to feed. Plus they all coming to the temple to make a sacrifice. But as we look at our lesson on this morning, when they get there, someone is going to help them exchange their currencies. This was a great time of year. Let's just say it was equivalent to the Christmas season. You see, when the Christmas season is coming around, all the malls and all the shopping centers, well, let's just say that they start making a killer. So they will be making a killer on this week. We all like to make money, right? And get a profit if we can every now and then. So what was so wrong about them making money? It wasn't so much wrong, Pastor, at them making the money. It was how they was making the money. Jesus is still cleaning the temple. Matthew 21 and 13 picks it up and says, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you are making it out of a den of robbers. Perhaps some price was being gouging, what's going on. But this is not the focus on Jesus' anger on this morning. But according to John, as far as John was concerned, Jesus is upset because all the buying and all the selling has been introduced upon the sacred space for worship. You see, we don't supposed to put anything before God and worshiping Him. In John's gospel on this morning, Jesus says in John 2 and 16, take these things out of here. You see, He's an angry God right now, because the word of God lets us know that we can get angry and sin not. You see, God is a God that's perfect. So He didn't sin, but He got angry. He began to tell them to stop making my Father's house a marketplace, a house of merchandise. You see, right now, so many people is making God's house of prayer out of an entertainment. They turn from the temple and exchange the house, and yes, God is very angry. Sometimes we get caught up in some serious sins, and before we know it, we are in the hands of an angry God. I don't know about you on this morning, but I don't want to be in the hands of an angry God. Let every man examine himself. You see, when sin begins to reign in our spirits, God already speaks to us that it's coming upon us. But it's up to us to stop and yield and get everything all right. Jesus said on this morning, I come to clean the temple. Talking about this spiritual temple. Don't get caught up on the treasures of the earth that will doom you to hell. That temple has become a marketplace, a place of bazaar, but it has lost its sacred character. What kind of character are we betraying on this morning? They have lost sight of everything that they was told to do. They've lost sight on holy ground. People is doing any and everything on holy ground. But there's an angry God that's sitting in heaven. Say, get it right. Get it cleaned up. Hallelujah. To your name. We don't respect the house of God like we used to. Making it out of a house of entertainment. But I stopped by this morning to let you know that God say He's coming to cleanse us up. It's up to you and it's up to me to hear the voice of the Lord. So now Jesus drove out all the merchants, the sheep, and the cattle, and He brought everything to a halt, and they had the audacity to ask the question, what authority do you have to come in our house and disrupt the temple? Who do they think that was talking to? Jesus, and had the nerve to call it their temple. But you see, people back then and here today, they get upset when it comes to that moolah that was upset because Jesus interrupted the sin that was in the temple. Hallelujah to your name. Jesus coming to clean the temple. What authority do we have to ask the Almighty God that's in the midst of it all? Hallelujah to your name. You think Jesus went to say, destroy the temple, and in 3 days He declared that He will raise it up. This is John's way of letting us know that the focus have been shifted from the temple to Jesus and to the prophecy of the death and the resurrection of the Lord. The point is the temple is truly a dwelling place of God. It should not be thought of a physical building. Hallelujah. To your name, but it should be thought of a place to worship Him in spirit and in truth. It should be thought of a place to assemble ourselves. Hallelujah. To your name. sent to Jerusalem or any other building for that matter. Hallelujah to your name. And what this means for us on this morning is that the temple of God today is to be felt in the hearts and the minds of those who honor him wholeheartedly. Are you honoring him wholeheartedly on this morning? Do your temple needs to be cleansed? He's here on today to do just that. Do you remember when Paul talked to the Corinthians? Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you? We are the temple of the living God in this world on today. And there is where the cleansing hits home for us as we consider the many ways we've become relaxed in our spiritual disciplines and soften in our resistance to evil thoughts and destructive behaviors and accommodating to this circular world. But God is angry. Get your hearts in order. He's coming to clean the temple. He's coming to cleanse the temple. Are you ready to be clean? Well, I know some say we ain't perfect, and you are right, because the word of God tells us we all fall short of his glory, meaning we all sin and we all erring. However, before we get too far in a backsliding spirit, hallelujah to your name, we repent and get back on track with the Almighty God. It's a subtle process, turning the temple into a marketplace according to our lessons on this morning. Jesus is cleaning the temple. Whether we be honest with ourselves, sometimes our house we live in, a little dust and a little dirt builds up on baseboards and the hard to reach places, the nooks and crannies, the rooms, lint balls, and mildew too. Hallelujah to your names. Sometimes forms of the shower stall and the bathtubs needs cleaning. We get our products together and we begin to clean that natural house. Cobwebs hiding from the ceiling. We get something and dust it off. Hallelujah to your name. From the ceiling to the floor. But all of this happened at a slow process that we hardly notice the dust. But one day an alarm goes off and we come to our senses and we realize it's time to do something. Spring cleaning is on the way, and we put our houses back in order where this spiritual man needs spring cleaning to get our house back in order. Jesus is cleaning the temple. It's not too late to clean out the noose and crannies in this spiritual temple on this morning. You see, he is a lint ball remover. He removes the small sins from our lives before they become too visible and out of hand. We don't want to get up caught up in the nooks and crannies. If you are there, there is a way of escape. What about the mildew? Well, Deuteronomy 28 and 22 picked it up and said it declares as part of a curse for disobedience. The small life spoke, the Lord smite thee with constipation and with fever and inflammation and with an extreme burning and with the sword and the blasting of mildew. And they shall pursue them until thou perish. When you see disobedience is a mildew. I hear God say on this morning, obedience is better than sacrifice. Jesus is cleaning the temple. God will not lead you wrong. Hear the voice of the Lord on this morning. Obey and reap the harvest of the Lord. Get rid of all the coffee stains that appears on the carpet. I feel my help coming on. I'm just about finished. Yes, I am. But clean up all those carpet stains of the heart of shame and selfishness and scars from the past. Cobwebs on the ceiling. Pull that dust down and send up some timber into the hills from which your help coming from. Jesus wanted to clean your temple. He wants to cleanse my temple. Matthew say, what we bind on earth will be bind in heaven. What be loosed on earth will be loosed in heaven. Hallelujah to your name. Heaven is what's been loosed. Heaven is what's been bound. We got to be about our Father's business. Hallelujah to your name. Psalms 51, around the 10th verse, pick it up and said, create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. Jesus is here to clean the temple. Hallelujah to your name. You need cleansing on this morning. We got a God that sits high and looks low and is ready with his arms wide open. Hallelujah to your name. He's a God of the great I am. He's a God, hallelujah, that loves. Yes, he is. He's a God of Alpha and Omega, the beginning, the end, the Jehovah Rapha, the Jehovah Retire. Yes, he is. Who wouldn't serve a God just like that? You see, he gave his only begotten Son that we may have the right to the tree of life and clean up what we messed up and start our life all over again. You see, he's a God that can't lie, shall not lie, and won't lie in the terms of the young folks. You see, he's incapable of capping. Yes, he is. Hallelujah to your name. You see, he hung on the cross. He could have came down at any given time, but he knew that he was going to have his Son clean up my mess and clean up your mess. Hallelujah to your name. It's time that you choose this day to be cleansed from unrighteousness. Souls, yes it is. You see, he suffered upon the Pontius Pilate. He was beat with 39 whips. I think the 40th one would have killed him, but they chose not to kill him because they wanted to suffer a mean, bad, suffering death. But he stood, and he stood right there. He laid on the cross with nails in his hand, with nails in his feet. They had the nerve to pierce him inside. Yes, they did, but he stood right there. But there's good news on the cleansing of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You see, he died and was buried, but on the third day, he rose from the dead and declared victory over the grave, death, and hell, so that you and I could be cleansed. Who wouldn't serve a God just like that? Jesus is coming. Yes, he is. And that right early, will you be ready? When he comes, will you be cleansed? When he comes, if you need to be cleansed, if you need love, he's got it. If you need joy, he's got it. he sent his son in order to give it to us. Do you want to know this morning? Hallelujah. Do you want to be cleansed from your unrighteousness on this morning? That is the word on this morning. And I'm a vessel that believes in being obedient to his voice. He said that was the word and that was enough. Hallelujah. And I hearkened my ear and to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that came that you and I may have the right to the tree of life. He simply just came and spoke through me on this morning to tell you and me, because we preach to ourselves first, to take a cleansing, to look in the mirror and examine our own selves of our cleansing. We don't want to be caught up in this temple in the hands of an angry God, because we're not doing, we're not walking, we're not talking in the right mind, in the right spirit. But I say on this morning, wherever you may be at, God's got it. He's got the power. He's got the anointing. He's got the authority to cleanse anything that needs cleansing in our lives. I pray that something has been said on this morning to help you along the way, to let you know that we serve our almighty God that can do anything but fail. And he never lost a battle. Who don't want to be on the winning side on this morning? If you don't know him as your Lord and Savior, you're not on the winning side. It's just as simple as that. I don't come to sugarcoat God's holy and righteous word. But he declared me to preach and teach his word in season and out of season. And yes, sometimes the word of God hurts. But the word of God also declares that the word cuts like a two-edged sword. And if you're being cut by a two-edged sword, and you feel like the preacher hurt you, the preacher didn't hurt you or the church, it's the word of God is cleansing you. The word of God is supposed to cut that we'll get it right. We'll do better today than what we did on yesterday. Hallelujah. That is where Jesus is cleaning the temple. And if you don't know him in the pardon of your sins, wherever you may be at right now, all you got to do is cry out to him and say, Lord, I believe that you gave your only begotten son. And I believe that he raised from the dead in 3 days and declared victory over the grave, death, and hell. Lord, forgive me for my sins. Hallelujah. And you are saved. Don't worry about what you got to clean up, because that's where Jesus comes in at. Just be saved on today and work on that daily. None of us has gotten where we at overnight, but it's a growing process. Don't let the devil listen to your ear. Don't you listen to the devil in your ears for him to tell you that you're not worthy. It's nothing too hard for God to clean up. You have not sinned so bad that you cannot be cleansed by the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Oh, heavenly and righteous Father, here we are again, God, standing in a need of prayer. Lord, I just thank you right now, God, for your goodness and your mercy, God. Oh, God, that suits our case. Lord, I thank you right now, God, how you stood behind me and the whole house of heaven stood as I delivered your word. Lord, I thank you how you let Rosemary sit down, that you stood up in me on this morning. Hallelujah. And I tell you, thank you, God, for what you're doing, what yet you're going to do. Lord, now you look upon your people on this morning, Lord. Touch them like never before, Lord. Cleanse them from the inside out, Lord. Creating them a new spirit, God. Oh, God, cleanse their heart, Lord. You are the creator, God, and create, God, righteousness within our hearts. Lord, you already know and sees the heart. And, Lord, we tell you right now to help us, God. Oh, God, along the way, Lord. Oh, God, touch that one, God, that's closest to hell, Lord. Oh, God, let them say, come, brother, say, what must I do to be saved? Oh, God, let them know, God. Oh, God, that you're standing right there, God, with your arms wide open. But, God, let them know, God, you're waiting for them to knock on the door, Lord, that you may open it, God, and fill their minds, their soul, their hearts, and their spirits, God. Oh, God, with your cleansing, Lord. We just magnify and we praise you, God. Oh, God, for everything, God, that you already doing, what you're going to do, God. Oh, God, in your temple, God, in our temple, God, spiritually, Lord. We thank you and we praise you, Lord. Oh, God, for being so good, for being so almighty, God. Oh, God, for just being so merciful, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, breathe upon your people right now, Lord. Oh, God, like never before, Lord. Touch right now, God. Oh, God, our pastor right now, Lord. Continue on blessing him, God. Oh, God, continue on pouring down your wisdom, your knowledge, and your understanding, Lord. Oh, God, he may lead your people, God. Oh, God, touch Coach Shepherd Free Will Baptist Church family right now, God, like never before. Oh, God, we know you able, God. Keep them cleansed, God. Oh, God, in your spirit of righteousness, God. Oh, God, touch each and every one, God. Oh, God, that's looking on this morning, Lord. Cleanse them right now, right, God, God, in the name of Jesus, God. We know you able, God, and we know you can. We just love you and we praise you. This is our prayer, blessed in the name of the Father, Son, and precious Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen and amen. And at this time, we're going to put this part of the service in the hands of our pastor, Dr. Alfonso Surles, for the last remarks and benediction.
Thanks, Dr. Surles, for the word on this morning. Brothers and sisters, she preached Jesus is cleansing the temple. You can best believe the devil understands and comprehends that Jesus has cleansed the temple and that he wants to cleanse your temple. But he's not going to let go of that grip that he has on your life. He's certainly not going to let go of that strong man that he's placed before you, that follows you everywhere you go, that don't want you to reason that God died for you and came into his own. Because once you begin to reason that he did, you begin to comprehend that you will get your freedom. Brothers and sisters, the enemy is all around. We have better understand that when God knocks on your door, remember the temple is God's house. And God was in his house and God wants to come into you so that he may be a part of your house. So when he knocks on your temple, open the door and let him in. And you can best believe the enemy has set up roadblocks because he is not gonna give up that easily, even though the battle has already been won. Remember, you're not fighting against Satan. Remember, you're not fighting a battle that has been lost. You're fighting a battle that has already been won. Amen. But the enemy knows the only way to stop you is to change your mind and to make you forget that the victory is over. But let God cleanse your temple on this morning. Once again, we thank Eldress Surles for the word on today. May heaven bless you and may heaven continue to smile upon you. Once again, I'm Pastor Surles. This is First Lady Eldress Rosemary Surles coming to you from Coates Chapel Free Will Baptist Church. We pray that God has said something through this vessel that's going to encourage you, brothers and sisters, that's going to help you turn around and seek his face and believe without any doubt that he is there and he is capable of sustaining you in your time of need. Once again, God bless you. May heaven smile upon you.